There's a lot of confusion going about the Pegasus project, whether it is authentic or not. And until 3 hours ago, this video was supposed to be about why the Pegasus project is unreliable. But since then, some new information has come to my attention. Therefore, the topic of this video now is why the Pegasus project is most probably authentic. Before I present my arguments regarding the Pegasus project, a quick recap. Pegasus project is a group of 16 news organizations from across the globe, working together to find the victims of the Pegasus spyware, developed by an Israeli technology firm called the NSO Group. The Pegasus project was started by a France-based not-for-profit organization called the Forbidden Stories, when it discovered a list of 50,000 phone numbers from 50 countries. It was claimed that these phone numbers belonged to the potential victims of the Pegasus spyware by the NSO Group. Who gave them this list? We don't know. Also, this isn't the first time the NSO Group has been in the news. In 2019, the group made headlines for hacking WhatsApp. The list of numbers the Forbidden Stories found only had phone numbers, but they did not know to whom these phone numbers belonged to. So they sought the help of the Washington Post, The Guardian, and 13 other news organizations from across the globe to find out the owners of these phone numbers. And it was discovered that these phone numbers belonged to journalists, human rights activists, diplomats, teachers, academics, criminals, politicians, and even heads of states. After that, these news organizations contacted some of the people whose number was on the list and requested them to give their phones for forensic examination to see if they were hacked by the Pegasus or not. Out of the 50,000 phone numbers, they only managed to get 67 people to give their phones for forensic examination. The forensic examination of these phones were done by the Amnesty International Security Lab. The Pegasus software is famous for hacking into a phone and disappearing without leaving any trace of a hack taking place, which was true until now. It has been discovered that Pegasus does leave tidbits of codes in the phones that it hacks, and these codes were discovered by the Amnesty International Security Lab, and they found out a way to discover if a phone was hacked by the Pegasus or not. It is easier to discover these codes on Apple's iPhone, but not on Android, because Android does not save this data. Out of the 67 phones examined, only 23 showed signs of a successful hack, and 14 showed signs of an attempted hack. The forensic examination done by the Amnesty International Security Lab was independently verified by an organization named the Citizens Lab. The WhatsApp hack by NSO I talked about earlier, it was the Citizens Lab that helped in that investigation. Amnesty International has put up its forensic examination along with all the codes that show signs of a Pegasus hack for everyone to verify. Therefore, for now, I trust Amnesty International's forensic examination. The entire Pegasus project depends on the 50,000 phone numbers discovered by the Forbidden Stories. Therefore, to check if the Pegasus project is reliable or not, we first need to examine the authenticity of the 50,000 phone numbers. According to the Pegasus project, the 50,000 phone numbers is a list of phone numbers in which NSO's clients, that is most probably the governments, had some interest in hacking. It doesn't mean they hacked it. It means that it just showed some interest in those phone numbers. Even though the phone numbers list has not been made public yet, we know from news sources that the list had three pieces of information: the phone numbers, the country codes of those phone numbers, and timestamps. That is the date and time when interest was shown in these numbers by the NSO's clients. Previously, I did not know that the list also had timestamps. And I was baffled to see how these news organizations were able to make such grand claims that the French President Emmanuel Macron's phone was possibly hacked in 2018 by Morocco from just a list of phone numbers. But the presence of date and time on the list changes everything. The presence of date and time on the list can help us authenticate the list itself. By comparing the date and time when interest was shown in these phone numbers with the date and time when these phone numbers were actually hacked, we can tell if the list is authentic or not. And the Pegasus project did exactly that. It went out and asked the people whose number was on the list to give their phones for forensic examination. As you already know, out of the 67 phones examined, only 23 showed signs of a successful hack and 14 showed signs of an attempted hack. An attempted hack is when a target gets a link containing the spyware, but the target does not click on that link. Therefore, his phone does not get hacked. But this is old technology. Today, a target need not even click on a link for his phone to get hacked. Pegasus automatically hacks into a phone from just a text message. This is called no-click technology. So when Amnesty International checked the date and time of the phones that were successfully and attemptedly hacked and compared it with the date and time when interest was shown in these phone numbers, they found a strong correlation. This is a very nuanced observation, so let's take an example to understand this thing better. For example, there is a phone number on the list numbered 123, and interest was shown in this phone number by the NSO's clients at 1 p.m. on 1st January 2021. The Pegasus Project found this phone number, and the Amnesty International's forensic examination discovered that the phone number 123 was hacked at 1:15 p.m. on 1st January 2021, therefore showing a strong correlation between when interest was shown in these phone numbers as to when these phone numbers were actually hacked. In one case, the difference of time when interest was shown in a phone number as to when the phone was actually hacked was just 7 seconds. In conclusion, the probability of the 50,000 phone numbers list being authentic is high, and as a result, the credibility of the Pegasus Project is also high. Now, what remains to be answered is who leaked this list? Was this list leaked by an NSO employee? Or someone hacked into the NSO group to get this list? I also do not understand how these news organizations can tell that it was India who potentially hacked Imran Khan's phone and not Saudi Arabia or Israel. The phone numbers list does not say who showed interest in who. These questions need to be answered. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming onto my vlog. I'll see you soon.